Greetings and salutations, everybody. Anthony here from Anthony Around Town, or more rather these days, Anthony Around My House, because I'm currently doing what all of us should be doing right now, which is practicing social distancing, staying inside and doing my part to flatten that curve. So the big thing is, just trying to find things to do to stay busy. What's cool though is I've been able to catch up on a lot of things that have been on my list for a while that I just haven't had time to get to. Well, yeah, all very, very important things. Say that these are wild and uncertain times would probably be the understatement of the century. Many of us have so many things we need to navigate and work through, and this is just uncharted waters for so many of us. That's just the reality. But you know what I decided to do was use some of this extra time that I have right now hanging out in my house, not doing a whole lot, to experience things that I've never maybe have experienced before. I don't want to waste this downtime. Hopefully, prayerfully, everything will be going back to normal in the very near future. But in the meantime, I have a lot of extra time that I could use to take advantage of some sweet opportunities. And one of those sweet opportunities comes in the form of food. Yes, you see, for me, I've lived in the Elko area for almost 10 years now. And over those years, I've been able to frequent and experience a lot of fantastic restaurants here in the Elko area. However, in almost a decade of calling this place my home, there are still food dishes in this community that I have yet to ever try before. Heck, I even realized that there are a couple restaurants in town that I've never eaten at before. And I'm Anthony Around Town, not Anthony kind of around town or at most places around town. No, I have to experience all that Elko has to offer, and that's what I'm going to do today. Today, I'm going to use my lunch and dinner time to try out two food dishes I've never had before here in Elko. I don't know if the reason why I haven't diversified my palate is because I'm a picky eater or anything like that, because I'm not. I like trying new foods. I think the better way to describe me when it comes to my meal preference is that I'm more of a predictable eater, if you will. I know the stuff that I like, and especially when I'm going out and spending money, I gotta get the dishes I know for a fact are going to be satisfying to my taste buds. But that's not the point of today. The point of today is to be adventurous, to be spontaneous, to try new things, to put myself out there a little bit, and to walk away saying, today I tried something new. So this morning, what I did is I sat down and I thought about it, and I was able to put together a list of 5 different food dishes I've never tried before. The things on my list are anything from Machi's. Yeah, believe it or not, I've lived here for almost 10 years, have still never eaten at Machi's. That could change today. Anything from O'Day's Mediterranean restaurant. Yep, never eaten anything from there either. A burrito from Dos Amigos, eaten at Dos Amigos lots of times, but never actually got a burrito from that Mexican restaurant. That could change today. The Star Melt Sandwich from the Star Hotel has their name in it, so I'm assuming it's good. Just never had it before. And last but not least, fish tacos from Maddie's. I've heard before that Maddie's makes a mean fish taco, so that's going on the list. Now you might be saying to yourself, Anthony, Those are five different things from five different places. There's not that many meals in the day. How are you going to do all of that? The answer is I'm not. I'm just going to be getting something from lunch off of that list and then something for dinner off of that list. But because they all sound so gosh darn good, what I'm going to do is leave the decision on what to get for lunch and then later what to get for dinner up to my wheel of fate. Oh yeah. So for example, it's almost lunchtime. I'm getting very, very hungry. So we're gonna get ready to spin the wheel of fate and see what my lunch order is going to be. Before I spin the wheel of fate, wanted to talk for just a second about honestly why I'm so excited to do this today. And it's not just so I can try new foods. Like that's obviously a sweet bonus, but one of the big reasons why I'm excited to place these orders today is honestly just to support a couple local businesses here in my community. Obviously, throughout the last several weeks and into the near future, businesses have had a lot to figure out, a lot of different decisions to make, and have just done a lot of different things to really just continue to provide great service in our community. So I myself am always just excited when I can return the favor and help support businesses that are local, because there's fast food restaurants and stuff like that with items I've never tried before. But today I just specifically wanted to give my money, give my time to supporting a couple local businesses, because that's, you know, what being part of a tight community like this is all about. I know that times are rocky for a lot of people right now, especially financially, but if you do have a couple extra bucks and, you know, everybody has to eat, maybe just consider giving those dollars back to local businesses and keeping that money here in our community, or the businesses that have shut down because maybe, unlike the restaurants, they're not able to provide their services through delivery or takeout. Maybe contact the owner and see how you could still support them through this time, whether it be through a gift card or some other means. We're all neighbors here. We're all in this together. I know we're just going to come out the other side of this stronger as a town, as a community, as the people of Elko County. We just need to continue to do what we can to support each other through this. And speaking of which, before we spin the wheel of fate, I just want to turn your attention really quick to a few businesses that have really just supported Anthony around town specifically throughout this year. We couldn't do a lot of this and make a lot of this content. It just wouldn't be possible without these businesses. So check them out right now, and then we'll be right back to spin that wheel.
In these times, it's still really good and comforting to know that there are many businesses in our town that have our community's back. So many of them have donated so much of their time and energy and efforts to make sure that we who call Elko home still have some semblance of normalcy throughout this chaos. And three businesses that we know do that without a shadow of a doubt are the businesses that currently make up the Anthony Around Town sponsorship team. If you need to buy a house from somebody who cares about this town, get a hold of Jessie at the number below. She would love to talk to you, and her words to the community is that she and her entire team are praying for Elko, so give Jessie a call. If you're just looking to relieve a lot of stress and anxiety and just feel better mind, body, and spirit-wise throughout all of this, give Elise a call at the number below. I actually have the honor of getting to see Elise almost every single week, and we always have the best conversations, and her heart for other people in our area is just so big. So keep Heartwood Wellness in mind, especially, again, if you need a little TLC, and contact her if you can. And last but not least, if you're injured and you truly need somebody to fight for you, you need somebody genuinely on your side, then give Denise over at Bradshaw Law LLC a call at the number below. Denise is just such a hard worker. She's always on the phone and figuring things out and going here and there for her clients. She definitely has her clients back. She is willing to fight and work so hard for the people who entrust her with her service. So give her a call at the number below. I know you won't be disappointed if you need quality legal representation. Again, we're super thankful for all three of these businesses here at Anthony Around Town. These are scary times. These are unnerving times. These are, heck, even uncertain times. So I'm just thankful to live in a town that has one another's back the way that these businesses do. Thank you to all the other businesses out there that are currently working so hard to make sure that Elko stays a quality place to live, work, and play, even after all this is said and done. Thank you, thank you, thank you from the bottom of my heart. Now, back to the video.
All right, welcome back. Now, enough talk. I am very, very hungry. I didn't even eat breakfast. I know that's the most important meal of the day, but I just, being honest, I straight up didn't. So let's head over to the Wheel of Fate and see what I'm getting for lunch. The Wheel of Fate has spoken, so it looks like for lunch, I am trying O'Day's Mediterranean restaurant for the first time ever. So let's give them a call and put in our order. Can I put in an order for delivery, please?
Yeah, sure. What's your next order?
Can I do the shawarma sandwich, please?
What kind of meat do you like? Lamb or beef or chicken?
Let's do lamb.
The hummus with the fries?
Yeah, let's do hummus. Yeah, let's do that.
Most of the people, they like fries with the hummus. They can't dip the fries with the hummus.
Ooh, that sounds good. Yeah, this is actually my first time trying you guys out, so thanks for the recommendation. Order is placed. I'm so excited. He said it's gonna be about 20 minutes. It really does need to be here now because, again, I was dumb, didn't eat breakfast this morning, and now I'm starving. I guess I don't really have anything else to do but stare out the window until they get here, so let's go do that.
20 minutes later.
I think they're here. Oh yeah, super excited. Here we go. He's leaving now. We have the food in hand. That was a safe transaction. All is good. The man's driving away. And now we have our delicious lunch from O'Day's. My first time. Let's open it up and check it out.
Here we have a delicious lamb shawarma. Is it shawarma? Shawarma? Shawarma. Shawarma. Whatever. Sandwich. Looks good. With some hummus and some french fries. It smells amazing. Now time for the all important taste test. Okay, here we go. I'm gonna try it. But you don't wanna sit and watch a grown man chew his food. So here, let me throw in a cute picture of a baby duck. And I'll let you know how it tastes in 1 second. Whew, oh man, that was really, really good. How did I go this long without trying them? They're awesome. That shawarma had really great flavor. The lamb was cooked really well. The sauce that they have in there, excellent, love it. I got like the spicier option, so it definitely has some legit flavor in there. That hummus though, if you're gonna open a Mediterranean restaurant, you can't screw up the hummus. That's like opening a pizza restaurant and not being able to make a slice of pepperoni pie. Their hummus, legit, delicious, could eat that by the spoonful. So very glad overall that I decided to try O'Day's for the first time today. So now I'm gonna finish up my meal, and a little bit later, we'll let the Wheel of Fate decide what I'm gonna have for dinner. Oh hey, I hope the rest of your afternoon was good. Just did an interview and wrote a little bit for a new blog coming out over at anthonyaroundtown.com. But the day has gone by. It's actually moved along pretty quickly. So even though that shawarma I had for lunch from O'Day's was delicious, I just went ahead and digested that bad boy already. So I'm hungry yet again, so we need to head over to the Wheel of Fate and see what we're having for dinner tonight. The The wheel of fate has spoken yet again. Looks like we're having some fish tacos from Maddie's for dinner.
So I've been stuck inside the house most of the day working and whatnot. So I just decided to get a little fresh air, to change my scenery, if you will. Then I'm just gonna go take a little drive to Maddie's, roll down the windows, get some fresh air, and pick up my food rather than have it delivered. Because, you know, even in these times, driving 5 minutes down the road can seem like an adventure. So let's go. Gonna roll the windows down, gonna turn the music up, gonna cruise on over and pick me up some fish tacos. Let's go.
We're here.
Pardon my dirty windshield, but we made it to Maddie's. Just crazy how empty this parking lot over here is, but obviously that's to be expected. So gonna find out how to go about getting my food, and I will be back in 1 second to show you guys the goods. Waiting inside for my food. Such a bummer, so empty. Obviously this place normally would be hopping full of people, enjoying each other's company, but this is why it's so important just to stay home, practice social distancing, so we could fill local businesses like this up again. Back in the car, checking out the tacos. They smell amazing. Oh my gosh, can't wait to get home to take my first bite. So I got the tacos, then I also got myself a nice sparkling margarita, because even though we're social distancing and quarantining ourselves, that doesn't mean we still can't party, right? See that? Here we are with taco number one. All right, about to try my first ever fish taco from Maddie's. But again, you don't want to sit and watch a grown man chew his food. So while I munch, you take a look at this really cute armadillo. Man, that was delicious. My compliments to the chef. The fish was nice and crunchy. The sauce on there, awesome. The Wheel of Fate definitely knows what it's doing when it comes to choosing food, because both my lunch and dinner today, 10 out of 10. But I'm sure whatever the Wheel of Fate would have chosen off of that list would have been awesome. Seriously guys, we're blessed to have some really fantastic local businesses and restaurants in our community. So I gotta emphasize again, during this time, if you have the means, if you're able, let's just continue to support them in any way that we can. Buy a gift card, get takeout, get delivery. Talk to them about how you can have their back through this all, because throughout the years, I'm sure many of you know this, especially if you've lived in this community for a while, a lot of our local businesses have done so much to have our backs. Whether that's donating to our kids' school programs or sports or just helping out the town through a crisis. This is really, you know, just what it means to be in this thing together. So keep that in mind over the next couple of weeks. Thank you again to all of our local businesses for what you're doing to make sure that Elko continues to be a wonderful place to live. But you know, I still have some places I need to try. Obviously, I only got to 2 of the 5 places on my list today, so I need to make my way through the other ones eventually. And what did I leave off of my list that I should have tried? What should I try next? Comment below, let me know where I should go, because I'm always ready to try new things. And speaking of which, I got a plate full of fish tacos to my right that I need to get to. So we're gonna get ready to wrap up this Anthony Around Town video. If you're watching this on YouTube, make sure you just hit like and subscribe down below so you can stay up to date on all the content that comes out from our channel in the future. If you're watching this video on Facebook, maybe consider heading over to our Facebook page and giving that page a like. We do cool stuff over there all throughout the week. If you wanna stay up to date on all the content that comes out from Anthony Around Town, whether that be videos like this, our blogs, live streams, podcasts, all that sort of good stuff, then you can just head over to our main site. There's the address below, anthonyaroundtown.com. Super simple, and you'll see all of our content housed over there. All right, guys, well, that's gonna do it for this Anthony Around Town video. I'm Anthony Crosby. So until next time, stay safe, stay healthy, and eventually, soon, we'll see you around again, Elko. Oh,